morning, and on behalf of the Sheriff's Office, we want to thank the Simpson family. We want to thank the news media for being here today. At 3:40 on Christmas Eve, 2016, Calvin Jerome Simpson, better known as CJ Simpson, the second, was shot to death in the doorway of his home after answering a knock at the door. The address is 159 Norfolk Drive in Reidsville, North Carolina. The shooter then fled the area, and this investigation remains open. Today is the day about CJ and his family, and we're asking anyone and urging anyone that may have information about the murder, no matter how insignificant they may think it is, to contact the Rockingham County Sheriff's Office at 336-634-3232, or you can call the Rockingham County Crime Stoppers at 336-349-9683. Callers can remain anonymous and can receive a cash reward for information leading to the arrest. At this time, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Simpson, Calvin's father, and his family. They will speak and they will give a plea for the public to have, if they have any information concerning this investigation, to please call the Rockingham County Crime Stoppers or the Rockingham County Sheriff's Office. Mr. Simpson.
Thank you. I'd like to say good morning to everyone. Again, thank you for being here. Like the detective said, this day is about our son, CJ. And that's what we are here for and to focus on. I definitely want to thank my family and friends for their support and love throughout this, because without them, none of this would be possible for us to continue to, you know, make it day by day. Like the detective said, this plea is for those who may have information about CJ. It's tough to deal with day by day. Folks ask about how you're doing, and that's great, but day by day, it's not a day to go by. We don't think about CJ. I told the detective, when I hear the birds singing, I think about CJ. When I wake up and see a beautiful day like today, I think about CJ. So this plea is for someone who has never felt this pain before. To wake up on Christmas Eve and get a phone call that your loved one is no longer with you is the toughest thing I've ever experienced in my life. What we're here for today is justice for CJ. That's what our plea is. In addition to what Crime Stoppers is putting out there for information, the family also has a reward, and that value is going to be $10,000 for anybody to take. The first person comes forth with information that leads to a conviction and arrest and conviction on CJ's death. Because, you know, this is so painful, no one should have to bear this.
And I just wanted to say, please, if anyone knows anything with any information, please come forward. Because CJ was our only child. So please, if anyone has any information that can arrest this person and get this person off the street, because God knows, I don't want any other family to have to go through what we're going through now. So please come forward. Please find it in your hearts to come forward to help us. We really appreciate it. Thank you so much.
As Jackie and Calvin just said, it's so difficult to even plan for Christmas, to put up your Christmas tree, or to even go shopping, because all you can think about is what happened this time last year. We lost our nephew in such a tragic situation. What I wanted to say is there's this climate out here today where people don't want to talk and provide information because you feel that you might be harmed in some way. But I plead and ask you to think about his mom and his dad and our family and the pain that we're going through because you want to remain silent. If you know anything, break this code, this snitching, please come forward, provide the information so that we can have a little bit of peace this holiday season. Share whatever information, no matter how small it may be, or how you may think it's insignificant. Please break that code of silence and come forward for us during this holiday season.
We have one last family member. Because we can't touch, we can't talk to, we can't tell them how much we love them. So we do it through action. This family is not unique. The story is not unique. But unfortunately, it happens too far, too many times, and too often. We're pleading that anyone who has information, please contact local law enforcement and give them the information they need to bring this family closure. In the end, we just want peace. We don't want vengeance. We don't want anything that is not due to this family, but we do want justice. So please contact local authorities if you have any information.
Good morning. My name is Larry Donnell Simpson Jr. CJA was my cousin, my only cousin. My family has definitely experienced trauma. It's something that, nobody can put into words. Like they said, we don't want vengeance, we just want justice. CJ did not deserve to have a funeral in such nature. He deserved to have a funeral with his children and his grandchildren and great-grandchildren present. He was a gentle giant, if you knew him. He was definitely a humble guy who, he was just a special person. I mean, he was virtuous, and at the same time, he could, hold a conversation with the common man. So he was definitely special to us. And we just are asking whoever knows anything or if you're responsible, please just do the right thing and come forward. If you know who or heard anything, just please allow your conscience to move you and just do the right thing.
Good morning. Thank you all for coming. My name is Tim Simpson. I'm CJ's uncle. He was very dear to my heart. And I'm just asking anyone who knows anything, please come forth and tell the sheriff department, call Crime Stoppers. Just help us. Like I said, we don't want vengeance. We want justice served. That's all from the bottom of my heart. And just thank you so much.
My name is Laverne Foster. And CJ was my youngest nephew. And it's hard to get up here and talk to people, but all we want is justice for CJ, and it's very devastating to know that his murderer is still walking around, like my brother said, walking around still enjoying these beautiful days. So all we want is justice for CJ.
This time, we'll take a few questions that you might have.
Do you have any persons of interest, or have you guys received any tips thus far in the investigation?
The investigation is very active at this time, and we are currently working this case each day.
Do officers have a motive at this point?
We don't know what the motive is. Again, the investigation is currently open, and we're still actively working it.
How old was CJ?
26.
Did he have any children?
No.
And you said that he was your only son?
He was the only child.
Detective, what does it say about the community that it's been almost a year now and you guys are still asking for help from the community? What does it say about the community not helping you all out?
In this particular situation, as in others, there's a tendency for individuals that do have information in regards to situations like this, they just keep quiet. They don't give up any information, and that's one of the difficulties that we've had in this particular case is people not sharing information.
What will it take to break this case open?
Again, as investigators and as we work not only this case, we work other cases. And of course, you have to have physical evidence, you have to have witnesses, and those type things. And as you work your investigation and as your leads continue to come in, you build on those things that from evidence and also from your witnesses, you build on that. And that's what makes your case strong. So again, anyone, and we know that someone out there knows what happened, may even been present when it happened. Those are the type of things that helps us in these type of cases.
So are you guys looking for one suspect or is it more than one?
At the current time, we do not know.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys and girls for coming out today and helping us get the word out. And hopefully this will help to provide that one piece of the puzzle and the permission so that we can bring CJ's killer to justice.